In the last video, we went over the definitions of series and parallel. Today, we'll see how those definitions might help us to simplify circuits. Let's start today by introducing the idea of equivalent circuits. If we have two circuits, or portions of circuits, that give us the same relationship between current and voltages for all values of current and voltage, those segments or circuits are equivalent. For example, we might look at an arrangement of resistors with a source attached. If we were to analyze this circuit, we would find that the current being drawn from the source is 2 amps. If we were to look at this much simpler circuit, we would find that the current from the source is 2 amps. I'm not going to take time right now to prove that this would be the case for any value of source voltage. It is. If you doubt, pause the video and try a few different values. Confirm for yourself that the current drawn from the source will be the same for both circuits at various source voltages. Since these two configurations of resistors produce the same result, as far as the current voltage relationship from the source, we can say that they are equivalent. Namely, this is equivalent to this. How can we determine the equivalent circuit or resistance? Let's start by drawing a simple circuit with two resistors. We have a voltage source, Vn, and resistors R1 and R2. If we call the current from the source, In, and the current through the first resistor, IR1, and the current through the second resistor, IR2, we can then, by using Kirchhoff's current law, or KCL, write In equals IR1 equals IR2. Since all the currents are equal, let's simply call it I. We can then indicate the voltages across R1 as V1 and the voltage across R2 as V2. We can then, by KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, write Vn equals V1 plus V2. We can substitute Ohm's law, V equals R times I. Then we have Vn equals R1 times I plus R2 times I. Since I is common to both terms, we can factor it out. Then we have Vn equals I times a quantity, R1 plus R2. Alternatively, we can say Vn equals I times an equivalent resistance, Req. We can do the same thing with three resistors. If we have a circuit with resistors R1, R2, and R3, with a voltage source Vn, we can again call the current leaving the source In. We can define the voltages across the resistors as V1, V2, and V3. Since all the resistors are in series, by KCL, In goes through all of them, so there's only one current in the circuit. Then using KVL, we can write Vn equals V1 plus V2 plus V3. Substituting in Ohm's law, we have R1 times In plus R2 times In plus R3 times In. In is common to all the terms, so we can factor it out. Then we have In times a quantity, R1 plus R2 plus R3, which we can rewrite as In times R equivalent. Let's generalize this. We take an arbitrary loop of series resistors, R1, R2, etc., up to Rn, and define the current role of them as In. We can write that the input voltage is equal to the sum of the voltage drops across the resistors. By Ohm's law, each of those terms is the resistance times In. In is common to all the terms, so we can factor it out. If we substitute Req for all the resistors, we have defined the equivalent resistance of all the resistors. So the equivalent resistance of resistors is simply the sum of all those individual resistors that are in series.
We can summarize this by saying that series resistances add. This might make qualitative sense to us. Resistance is a measure of how much something opposes the flow of electricity, that is current. Connecting resistors in series is like stacking those resistances. So the total resistance increases when we add resistors. Before I go on to talk about parallel combinations, I want to talk about another concept. That's of conductance. Sometimes it is convenient to talk about how well a material opposes the flow of electricity. That's resistance. Alternatively, we can talk about how well a material allows the flow of electricity. That is conductance. Mathematically, conductance, symbolized by G, is the reciprocal of resistance. If we take this expression and substitute it into Ohm's law, we get a new expression. Voltage times conductance equals current. I bring this up because with resistors or conductors, in parallel, it is sometimes easier to work with conductances. Maybe this will be apparent if we just try it. Let's start with two resistors in parallel with a current source. We'll label them R1 and R2. Then we can define the current through each of them, IR1 and IR2. By KCL, the input current must equal the sum of the currents through each of the resistors. Since there are only two nodes in the circuit, there is only one voltage. Let's call it Vn. Remembering that Ohm's law can be written as current is equal to voltage over resistance, we can write the input current is equal to the voltage divided by R1 plus the voltage divided by R2. We can factor out Vn. Then we have the input current is equal to the voltage times the quantity 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. Or we can say the input current is equal to the input voltage times 1 over an equivalent resistance. Then 1 over the equivalent resistance is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2, which we can solve for the equivalent resistance as 1 over 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. Although there is no mathematical difference between this and what I'm about to show you, conceptually the following may be a little bit easier, or at least the equations are a little cleaner. Let's look at the same circuit. However, this time, let's treat the resistors as conductors instead. Current through the first conductance we'll call I1. Current through the second one we'll call I2. By KCL, the input current will be equal to the sum of those two currents. There are only two nodes in the circuit, so there's only one voltage, Vn. If we substitute Ohm's law, current is equal to conductance times voltage, into the equation, we have the input current is equal to G1 times Vn plus G2 times Vn. Vn factors out, and we can write this as the equivalent conductance times Vn, where the equivalent conductance is equal to the sum of the conductances that are in parallel. We can take the same idea and extend it to an arbitrary number of conductances in parallel. Given a current In connected to parallel conductances G1 and G2, with an arbitrary number of conductances out to Gn, the same analysis applies. The supply current In will be equal to the sum of all currents through the parallel conductances. The circuit has only two nodes, therefore only one voltage, Vn. We can write the KCL equations in terms of voltages by writing each conductance times the voltage Vn. All the way out to the conductance, N times Vn. But voltage is common to every term, so it factors out. We end up with the input current equals the voltage times the sum of conductances. So the equivalent conductance of parallel conductances is simply the sum of the parallel conductances. Since the parallel conductances add, the conductance of the combination will always go up. This might make sense to us by remembering that by connecting conductors in parallel, we're providing more paths for the current to travel through, so the current will be higher for the same applied voltage. In this video, we covered series and parallel combinations of resistors. Though for the parallel resistors, we turned them into conductances. We discovered that series resistors can be combined to an equivalent resistance by adding them. And since we're adding resistors, the equivalent resistance will always be higher than any of the individual resistances in the combination. We also discovered that parallel resistors can be easily combined by converting the resistances to conductances. Then the equivalent conductance can be found by adding all the conductances in parallel. That means that a parallel conductance always results in a higher conductance than any of the individual components. If we want to think about parallel combinations in terms of resistances, then the total resistance of the parallel combination would be smaller than the smallest resistance that is being combined.
That's all for today. Go out and make it a great one.